Hello everyone, welcome back. This is a update on the pickup truck build. I need to get to the back stuff. I could just take this crate out and I can get to that. Stuff in the back is things I don't use all the time, like my little M12 bandsaw, my water pump. I only use that for water heaters, M18 stuff, Pro Press. So anyway, I got two Milwaukee crates here, and then I have an organizer. It's about 6 inches, maybe seven, something like that. I use this for my bits, Sawzall blades, multi-tool blades, all that kind of stuff. Drill bits, hole saw kit, some more hole saws. A couple of M12 tools here. I still gotta go through this bag, some step drills. Probably this area I'll have a couple extra batteries sitting there ready to go. I always like to have some hand cleaner in the back of the truck. I have these hand wipes. I also have hand wipes on the side because sometimes I just don't feel like opening the side box, or depends where I'm at. So here's my electrical bag. Okay. So I got electrical in there. These two bags are empty. Then over here on this side, I have my vacuum, see these little toolboxes. These are for plumbing overflow tools. These are pack out carryalls. I use these to kind of like catch all, help me organize. But really the one of the best uses for that is, you know, like holding glues and things like that on jobs, or miscellaneous tools and other stuff. But for now, kind of, I have things in here that need to get put away in other places. And for right now, it's better to just, I'm just going to leave it there. Another crate, couple of crimp rings, 3/4, 1/2 inch. A lot of this stuff, I still have to kind of optimize the way I'm doing it. And then back here, I can grab these. I could have pulled that out a little more. Yeah, let me do that. Okay. So now I can get to these. And then here's some more organizers where it's more plumbing stuff. I have a broom here, my long drill bits and fiberglass rods. Okay, let me put this back. That does it with the truck vault. Let me put these back. Okay, this has been working out great for the ladders and the table, my DeWalt table. And I use this as a handle to get up and in and out of the truck. It's working great. Paper towels in the back. I still have all that room up there and on the other side that I can utilize. Decided to put conduit strap here and there. And the other day I had some rigid crates. I could fit three of them perfectly, like those, the ones up there. I could fit three of them. Eventually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fill this space in. See the little ledges right here? Well, there's ledges on both sides. You're able to put 2x4 across if this wasn't in here, so you could have another level. Well, I'm gonna use that, those pockets. I'm gonna go from there to there, and I'm gonna put plywood or OSB from here to the side of the truck bed there. This way, I'll be able to utilize the space underneath and above. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna put up here. Okay, side boxes. Here's my Pro Press and PEX. I got two organizers in there. Still have more glues and pipe dopes and stuff like that to put in here, but that's working out great. So I have a hand cleaner over here and also over here. I have more hand wipes and like I showed you in the truck vault. So, all right, now let's go to the driver's side. All right, so I have, this is my favorite plumbing bag. I love this thing. I actually probably want to carry another one. I do have like three of these. These side pockets are great for carrying glues and pipe dope and all kinds of crap like that. This is gonna stay behind my seat. Might put it in the back unless I need to use the back for something, then I'll just have it back here. But in order to get to my bottom drawer, I can open it and just kind of go like this, but probably easier to just move that bag. And so here I have some of my electrical meters, different meters for different things. This is empty. This is my AA and AAA batteries. And well, so far this is what it is. Pencils, markers, etc., etc. This is for toilets, so I'm gonna have I'll have wax rings in here, some flappers, some closet flange extension spacers, and liquid lock. This is another one with toilet stuff. This is kind of like a toilet kit where I have shims, Johnny bolts, and all kinds of good goodies in there. And then I have some fill valves. So that's that. And then up here, I have my expander, ProPex expander. My rigid camera, DeWalt radio. And then I'm gonna put a shelf up here and I'll be able to put something there. I could put a bag there, or I could put, I was thinking about putting my 12 volt vacuum there. While I'm driving, it's a good idea to have these pulled out and locked in, so that you don't have those drawers opening up behind you. All right, so we're on the other side. And here's my Milwaukee cable stapler, and then I have the DeWalt cable stapler behind that. I have the staples for them, and a couple fish tapes. Here I have my Romex coil unwinder. That's really awesome. I have a little bit of room here. Organizers, these come out pretty easy. This is electrical, this is electrical. They just fit in here without touching the rubber. This is my fasteners, so. Okay, that's that. This is my carpentry tool bag. This is like, kind of like a safety drawer. Gloves, earplugs, safety glasses. And this, I have the wood finish, the putties. I'm thinking the rest of this drawer I'll use for like touch-up stains. And then here I have just contractor bags. And then an organizer. I don't even have anything in that right now. I think what I'm going to do is buy the skinnier ones here. And so one here, one on the other side. I'll see you on the next video. Take care.